Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. In today's video, we're going to understand a very important topic about parameterization. We also call it data-driven testing. Now, parameterization means passing multiple data sets for the same test case or steps. Now, there can be many instances, guys, that as a tester we are testing something in which only input data is changing, but our steps are the same. So, there is no benefit of recording those test cases again and again. So, parameterization is one of the options we use in this case in which our test case will be the same, but we will be passing multiple set of input data into it. Now let's see how to implement it. First of all, we're going to create a test case. For that, you can click on this file, new test name, this test case, let's say parameter underscore new. Here you can get the solution name. So I'm just keeping it the same. We'll click on create button over here. The test case has been created. Now let's start the recording. First of all, we must keep in mind two things that should be open on your screen when you are recording one tool. First, the UFT, and second, the application you are testing. Thus, these two things should be open on your screen. Please make sure that you are not opening anything else on your screen, because if any other application is open, there is a tendency that UFT can capture that, or it will automatically navigate to that application. It's better to have your application under test and the tool with the help of which you are testing it, that is UFT only. Please keep in mind, these two tools should be open on your screen, nothing else. Now let's start the recording. As I told you last time, you have two options to record. One is this record, and the second option is over here. So I'm going to click on this. I'll go to record and run setting. So guys, this time I'm going to choose this option, record and run, on any open Windows-based application. So this option has no relation to parameterization. I just want you to understand the other option too. Now, whichever Windows-based application will be open on your screen, UFT will capture it. Because of this reason, it is very important that on your system, no other application should be open. Otherwise, UFT will navigate to that application. Keep in mind that only the application under test, that is your flight sample application here, and UFT should be open on your screen. So I'm going to click on OK over here and click on record. You can use this option. So guys, I'm going to capture this application. Now after logging in, you will be landed on this page and I'm going to record this page. Now I'm not recording login. I'm recording this because I will be performing parameterization here. So I'm recording this. I'm taking flight from as London and flight to. I'm choosing, let's say, Paris. I'm keeping the same date. I'm changing it to business. This is the class where you have three options, economy, business, and first. I'm choosing business. In the field number of tickets, I'm choosing 4. Click on find flights. You can choose any flight that matches your criteria. So, I'm choosing this. Click on select flight button. You will be landed on this page, passenger name. I'm entering the name of the passenger here. I'm going to pass multiple sets of values over here, and then we will see how UFT works on it. I'm going to click on order, and then you can click on new search. Now we will stop recording. So this is what my recording looks like. This is editor view. You can perform parameterization in both keyword and editor view. So first we will start with the keyword view. To go to keyword view, we will click on this option view and go to keyword view. This is what it's going to look like. I will be implementing parameterization on passenger name object. So under value column, you will see this value. Over here, Emily, you will double click on it and here you will see hash P. Click on this, you get 4 options. Over here, test action parameter, data table, and environment random number. We will click on data table. Add a new parameter, we'll keep it the same. Here in parameter name, we'll choose the name of columns. So, what will happen with data table? One table will be created in which you can enter multiple sets of values for the passenger name column. Now this option parameter name is asking for the column name under which you want to enter the different set of values for passenger name. So, I'm just keeping it as same as my object name. Although it's totally your choice what you want to put over here, I'll click on. Okay, now one table will be created in which you can enter multiple sets of data for passenger name. If you want to see that table again, we'll go to the view option here. Click on data and look at this table. It has been created with one value, Emily, which I have inserted at the time of recording. Now you can write down the different sets of values over here. So, let's say the second value I want to pass is Sam. Third value I want to pass is Scott. Now I want to test this recording concerning these three values. So, I am passing multiple sets of values for one recording. Let's see how to perform it now. We're going to click on this run option over here. So, look at this. It chose Emily first, then again, it executed. Sam has been chosen in the second iteration, again it executed, and Scott has been chosen in the third iteration. This is how the same test case with multiple sets of data has been executed. If you see the report, you will see iteration number 1, so all test cases passed. So it is 100% passed. And if you look at the iteration, this is iteration number 2, and this is iteration number 3. So you can individually also look at the iteration number and how long it took. This is the execution time, and this is the duration. So, this is how you can implement parameterization in keyword view. Now we will understand how to implement parameterization in the editor view. To do so, we're going to again create a new test case. For that, you have two options. Either you can click on this plus sign, or go to File and follow the same process which we did in our previous videos, and even in this video to create a test case. Now we're going to explore this feature over here. We have already worked on this. So we're going to work on this plus sign. Click on that. It will automatically pop up that test case window. Now here I'm going to name it as editor_parameter. We'll click on Add. So a new test case has been created. We'll click on Record. Now again, we're going to capture the same window. I'm going to choose fly from as Paris, fly to as London. I'm going to keep the same date. I'm changing class to first and at number of tickets, let's keep it as 4. Click on find flights. Choose any flight matching your criteria. Click on select flight. Here again, I'm passing the passenger's name. Let's say this time I'm passing Scott. Click on order. And then we'll click on New Search. Stop recording from here. By default, you are lending to Keyword View because you have set it up as Keyword View. Let's switch it to Editor View again. We will go to View Option and go to Editor. So, this is your complete script. So now I will be performing parameterization on Number of Tickets option. Let's pass different sets of values over here. For that, you will be going to Tools option over here. Choose Data Driver, and here you will get a list of all the constant values on which you can implement parameterization. I know number of tickets is 4. If you want to cross-check, you can do it from here. So, you have few options. This is your economy, business, and first class. Then you have London, Paris. This is your fly from and fly to, name of the person, and number of tickets. These are the fields in which you can implement parameterization. So, I'm going to implement parameterization. This is 4 because I know this is the number of tickets value. This is the constant number of tickets. So, I'm going to choose this and then click on parameterize. We'll go to this option, parameterize all. So now here, you have this parameter option, where the global sheet address is given. If you want to modify any value over here, you can click on this pen and pencil the sign over here. So, you all are familiar with this table. In the keyword view parameterization, we came across this. So it is the same table here in the parameter name. you can change it and keep it as a column name. In this case, it is number of tickets. So I'm just keeping it as number of tickets. Click on OK. We click on Finish over here. Now we're going to scroll it up. You can see number of tickets. It's 4 over here. This is the value that I passed at the time of recording. And now I want to pass multiple sets of values. And for that, you can write down the values over here, let's say 5. And one value I want to enter as, let's say 9 again. Let's get started with the execution. For that, you will click on this run option over here. Click on run. So, the execution initiated first, it chose 4. This is the first iteration. Now look at the second iteration over here, it chose 5, and the third iteration started, and it chose 9. This is how we can implement parameterization in both keyword and editor views. And you can see it passed, 100% execution is done. All the test cases and all the steps have been passed. So guys, this is parameterization, which has a lot of advantages. You can pass multiple sets of data for the same test case, which saves our time and memory. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time, or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.